Yeah.
Welcome to VLSA for All. In this video, let us discuss about some digital interview questions on counters. If we know completely about the counters, then we can answer any questions on them. So I'm going to explain completely about the counters. First question, what is binary ripple counter? Ripple counter is a cascaded arrangement of flip-flops where the output of one flip-flop drives the clock input of the following flip-flop. That means the flip-flops are arranged in the form of cascaded, and the outputs of one flip-flop will be connected to the other flip-flops. It acts as a counter. The number of flip-flops are arranged depends on the number of logic states it's going to count. So an n-bit triple counter can count up to 2 power n states. That means if we have taken a 3-bit triple counter, then it can count 2 power 3, total 8 states. It is also known as modern counter. It is known as ripple counter because the clock pulses ripples its way through the flip-flops. Here are some of the features of ripple counter. First one is, it is an asynchronous counter. When we have given same clock to all the flip-flops, then it acts as a synchronous counter. But here we have given clock only to the first flip-flop, and the remaining flip-flops are driven through the outputs of the previous flops. So it is an asynchronous counter. Next, different flip-flops are used with their different clock pulses. I have already seen that. Next, all the flip-flops are used in toggle mode. We know that JK flip-flop will be in toggle mode when both the inputs are given high. So here, for all the flip-flops, both the inputs are given a high input. So these flip-flops will act as toggle mode. Next one is, only one flip-flop is applied with an external clock pulse and another flip-flop clock is obtained from the output of the previous flip-flop. Already seen. Next, the flip-flop applied with an external clock pulse acts as LSB in the counting sequence. Here, for this flip-flop, we have given the clock. So, the output of this flip-flop will be LSB and this is the MSB. So, here Q0 is taken as LSB and QT is MSB. So we have used 3 flip-flops, so 2 power 3 total 8 states it's going to count from 0 to 7. So from 000 to 111 it is going to count. Next, timing diagram. Let us assume that the clock is negative edge triggered. So the above the counter will act as an up counter because the clock is negative edge triggered and output is taken from Q. See, whether the counter is going to count in up counting sequence or down counting sequence depends on the type of triggering and the output taken from. Okay. Consider negative edge triggering. Then if we take the output from the queue, then it acts as an up counting sequence. If we take the output from the complement of the queue, then it acts as a down counting counter. But in another case, if we consider positive edge triggering, then if we take the output from the queue, then it acts as a down counting sequence. And if we take the output from the complement of the queue, it acts as an up counting sequence. Okay. So, since we have taken the negative edge triggering, it acts as an up counting sequence. So the clock is given to the input of the first flip-flop. And all the flip-flops are in toggle mode. So at every negative edge of the clock, the first flip-flop output will be toggled. See here. Here at this negative edge, it is toggled from 0 to 1, and at next negative edge it is toggled again, and it is going to toggle at every negative edge of the clock. Next, the output of the first flip-flop is given as clock to the second flip-flop. So at negative edge of the first, this Q0, the output of the Q1 will be toggled. See here, at this negative edge it is toggled, and again at this negative edge it is again toggled, so on. And similarly, this output of the second flip-flop is given as clock to the third flip-flop. So at negative edge of Q1, the Q2 going to be toggled. Okay. Next. What is ring counter? Explain the types of ring counters. A ring counter is a typical application of the shift register. The ring counter is almost the same as the shift counter. The only change is that the output of the last flip-flop is connected to the input of the first flip-flop in case of the ring counter, but in case of the shift register, it is taken as output. Except this, all the other things are same. See the image, you can understand. See, the four flip-flops and the output of previous flip-flop is connected to the next flip-flop. It is same as shift register, but here in case of shift register, we will take the output here, but here this output is connected back to the first flip-flop as input. Since here the output is connected to the first flip-flop, it acts as a ring counter. See the bit. Next, the types of ring counters. There are two types of ring counters. First one is straight ring counter. It is also known as one hot counter. In this counter, the output of the last flip-flop is connected to the input of the first flip-flop. The main point of this counter is that it circulates a single 1 or 0 bit around the ring. That means same, the last flip-flop output is connected to the first flip-flop input, and the 1 or 0 will be circulates in this ring manner, so it's given the name ring counter. Here, the number of states is equal to the number of flip-flops used. Okay, see here. We used four flip-flops, so we have got four states, and again we are getting the initial state. Next one is twisted ring counter. It is also known as switch tail ring counter, walking ring counter, or Johnson's counter. Remember this name, Johnson counter. It is very important and mostly used name. We use mostly Johnson counter, not twisted ring counter. Okay, so don't forget this name. It connects the complement of the output of the last shift register to the input of the first register and circulates a stream of ones followed by zeros around the ring. The only difference between the straight ring counter and twisted ring counter is here we are connecting the complement of the last flip-flop output to the input of the first flip-flop. Okay, so it is a twisted ring counter. In twisted ring counter, number of states will be two times the number of flip-flops used. So we used four flip-flops, so the number of states will be 8. Next one, explain about the decade counter. We all know that decade means 10, so it's going to count 10 different states. And it resets to the initial state, that means it counts from 0 to 9, or we can also make to count any 10 states between the 0 to 15. See here, it is going to count 0 to 9, that is total 10 states. Next, this is the diagram. We have taken four flip-flops. Since we need 10 states to count, if we take three flip-flops, it can only count up to 8 states. That means it can count only 7, up to 0 to 7. Okay, but we have to count total 10 states. So we need four flip-flops, right? So we have taken four flip-flops, but here we have taken one NAND gate. The output of the Q1 and output of the Q3 are given as inputs to the NAND gate, and the output of the NAND gate is given to the clear inputs of all the flip-flops. Let us see why it is taken like that. See, the Q3 and Q1 are given to the input of the NAND gate. When the counter starts counting, it counts from 0 to 9. And when it comes to the 10th state, that is, 11th state, that is 10. 1010 is the binary representation of the 10. So when it reaches here, the Q3 and Q1 are ones here, okay? See, Q1, Q2 and Q3. So Q1 and Q3 are ones. When these both ones are given to the NAND gate, the output of the NAND gate will be 0. That 0 is given to the clear inputs of all the flip-flops. And these clear inputs are active low. So when the 0 is given to the active low input of clear, all the flip-flops are going to be reset. That is cleared. So all the flip-flops reaches to the state, okay, that is initial state. When it goes to the 11th state, that is 1010, it going to be resetted and again reaches to the initial state and again starts counting from 0 to 9. Okay, if it reaches the after reaching 9, next it counts 10. When 10 is when it reaches the 10, it going to be resetted and it goes to the 0. So that's how it going to be counted from 0 to 9, total 10 states. Okay, I hope you understand. That's all for now. Let us discuss the remaining counters in the next video. So thank you for listening this video.